Yo, what's good, YouTube? It's your boy Tezkashing back with another video, man. And today we got the best five SMG class setups for season 3 reloaded. I know season 3 reloaded been out for a while, but I had to get the best class setups for you guys. Some of these classes I just like having fun, so I play with them a little bit. But these are the best setups for these classes, man. And let's get right into it. Starting off with the MP5. Y'all already know, man, the GOAT. This is the GOAT. We got the VLK laser tuning right here, -0.44 for the sprint to fire speed, and then -41.13 for the aim downsight speed. Moving on to the barrel, man, we got the F-Tac M-Sub-12 barrel. We got this for the movement speed and for the damage. This thing shreds, bro. We got the recoil sentence, +0.42, and then +0.37 for the damage range. Moving on for the 9mm, the ammunition. We got +0.56 for damage range and +7.84 for the bullet velocity. Get this and use this. Then, of course, you know, we got to have the round drums, man. We got the 40-round mag. And then moving on, last but not least, we got the mirror recoil 56 stock. We got -2.84 for the aim down sight speed. And then we got it in the middle a little bit for the aim walking speed and aim idle, -0.15. Balance that out because you're gonna get the best of both worlds, aiming down sight and walking. It is disgusting. Get this bad boy and give it a try. Now, moving on to the next one, we got number 2. We got the ranked VASNEF, the best VASNEF in the game. For me, I love it. We got a 44-round mag, ammunition, 9mm overpress. Also, you guys can switch this. You guys can put on a barrel. You guys want to, you can switch and put on a barrel. I haven't used it because I lost a couple of gunfights with it, so I didn't use the barrel. But you guys can use the barrel if you want to. But me personally, I'm just going to use the ammunition. But anyway, let's get tuning. +0.50 for the damage range, +6.10 for the bullet velocity. And now we got the muzzle, the spiral V3.5. We got -0.77 for the aim down sight speed, and then +0.28 for the gun kick control. Laser, the FSS laser, man. We got -0.32 for the sprint to fire speed, and then -26.32 for the aim down sight speed. And then the stalk, we got -30.23 for the aim down sight speed, and then -1.47 for the aim walking speed. The VASNEF has no recoil, so walking speed for this bad boy is the best thing. It is disgusting. Also, if you guys do want to do another switch, you guys can take off the stock and put on the true tack rear grip for the aim down sight speed and sprint to fire speed. Up to you guys, but I use this and it is a beast. Moving on, honorable mention. The MP, what is that honorable mention? I'm tripping, I got honorable mention last. But the MP7, you guys can choose, it's kind of close. I know the MP7 got more range than the VAS, but up close the VAS shreds. They both shred, but it just come close third, man. Close third. We got the MP7, the Veil. Let's go with the ammunition first. We got the 4.6mm. We got +0.63 for the damage range, and then +7.55 for the bullet velocity. Moving on, we got the 50-round mag. You guys know y'all need that. You guys can do 60 if you want, but I use 50 because I play Ashika. So, it's just, you know, I like mobility. You know, I got to have the mobility to get around. Moving on to the rear grip, the soldier grip. We got -0.90 for the aim-down sight speed, and then -0.39 for the sprint to fire. We got to make it fast, we got to make it quick, and we got to make it hit hard. Moving on to the stock, we got -4.00 for the aim-down sight speed, and then +0.70. for the aim idle. Like I said, I like getting stuff in the middle so I can get the best of both worlds. I love that. I like making sure my gun is balanced. And then for the last but not least, we have the laser, the VLK, -0.39 for the sprint to fire speed, and then aim down sight speed is -44.42. That is what we have for the MP7. All right, man, moving on to the big bass P, man, the big daddy bass P. We have the crony mini for the optic, man. The tuning right here, -3.00 for the aim down sight speed, and -2.03 for far. And then we got the 50 round mag. Y'all know we need the 50 round mag on this bad boy. Now, moving on to the phase 3 grip. We really didn't tune this, but you guys can tune it if you want to. But I don't have this tuned just because I want the best of both worlds. I told y'all that. So we don't have that tuned. Moving on to the VOK laser, we got -0.42 for the sprint to fire speed, and then -14.81 for the aim down sight speed. And last but not least, we have the barrel, man. We already got speed, so we maxing out the damage a little bit. And then, like I said, I want the best of both worlds, so we got +0.50 for the recoil steadiness. We gotta have the best of both worlds. We need to be able to aim down sight and move. I'm big on movement. So that is what we have for the Bass P. Moving on. All right, man, we got the Big Daddy P90, man. This thing is absolutely crazy. If y'all seen the last video, we dropped the 30 bomb with this thing and it goes crazy. Let's get into the tuning. We got the GR33 light rail, -0.31 for the sprint speed, and then +0.35 for the recoil stabilization. Moving on to the Chrome Mini, man, we got -2.71 for the aim down sight speed, then -2.25 for far. Then for the laser, the VLK, we got -0.50 for the sprint to fire speed, and then aim down sight speed is -51. Make sure you guys have the right tuning, because this thing does have kick. If you guys are off by a little bit, man, make sure you have the right tuning, bro. Moving on to the barrel, we got +0.44 for the recoil steadiness, and then +0.37 for the damage range. And last but not least, we got the spiral muzzle, -1.0, and then +0.04 for the gun kick we control. Like I said, I gotta have them in the middle, man. Make sure you guys get the right tuning for this thing so you guys can hit and beam and move quickly as possible. I'm big on movement. Now we do have a honorable mention. We got the Fennec. Y'all know the Fennec been nerfed to the dirt because it's been OP for so long. But this thing right here is a up close killing machine. It's disgusting up close. From far, it is kind of bad. But up close, you should win most of your gunfights. We got the Fennec rubber for the rare grip. We got +0.35 for the recoil steadiness. And then sprint to fire speed, -0.35. This is just for fun, man. If you guys want to have fun around Ashika, use this Fennec mag 45. Y'all know we gotta get the mag. Then the ammunition, the 0.45 auto, we got +0.63 for the damage range, and then +6.97 for the bullet velocity. And then the VLK laser, they all got different tuning for the laser. I know I got the lasers on almost all of them, but that's for the gun to aim down sight faster. And they all got different tuning because they all got different handling. But -0.37 for the sprint to fire speed, and then aim down sight speed, we got -41.13. And last but not least, we got the spiral flash, -0.45 for the aim down sight speed, and then +0.34 for the gun kick we control. This is for the muzzle, man. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to your boy Tezkashing, and I'll catch y'all in the next one. These are the best submachine guns for season 3 reloaded, and I would love to see y'all shred with these things, man. Not just me, but y'all too. But anyway, catch y'all in the next one, man. We out.